Here's Reverend Dr. Sheldon E. Williams and Principle Centered Living on AM 570 WMCA, New York's Christian Talk.
Good afternoon, everyone. This is the Reverend Dr. Sheldon E. Williams, and you're listening to Principle Centered Living Radio on WMCA 570 on the dial. We thank God for all of those of you who have been listening to us on a weekly basis. We pray that we're continuing to be a blessing to you, and we thank our new listeners, those who may be listening for the first time or the second time. We pray that this show is a blessing to you, and we just pray that you would continue to tune in every Friday afternoon at 1:30. I'm here, as I always am, with my co-host, Brother Mark Grant. How you doing, Brother Grant?
Better than great, beyond blessed as always, Dr. Williams, and overjoyed to be here ministering to people out there in Radio Land.
Yeah, we thank God for that, and we truly do have a minister today. We have a blessed guest. He's a young man who's been on before, and he's backed by popular demand. We're going to let Mark introduce you to him so that we allow you to get as much of his time and his knowledge and wisdom as possible.
Absolutely. We're very delighted to bring back to the WMCA 570 AM airwaves, none other than Reverend Anthony Evans. And of course, for those people who heard the show and might remember, he is the founder of the National Black Church Initiative out of Washington, D.C. Reverend Evans, welcome back to the PCL radio show.
Reverend Sheldon and Mark, it's good to be back. Praise the Lord.
Every time.
Good to have you. It's good to have you. Why don't you tell us some things about yourself and about the National Black Church Initiative?
Well, I'm from Savannah, Georgia. I reside here in Washington for the past 20 years. In that time, God gave me a great vision of pulling together African-American churches, some 34,000 across the country, to carry out his plan, but to also serve his people.
Now, you have a very good initiative that we really want you to highlight on this show, because Dr. Williams and I, we've had another guest on talking about the plight of men and what's happening in the country. Can you tell us more about the Bring Black Men Back to Church? I just like the name of it, actually. It's an attention grabber, that's for sure.
Yeah, I'm very happy to share with you. It's not good, it's great. It's a vision and revelation from the Lord Jesus Christ himself. And this is his very simple plea to me for the rest of my ministry. He told me to use the coalition of 34,000 black churches around the country to bring black men back to church. And when you bring them back to church, the church will look out, because when the men come back to church, the women will come back to church, and the children will follow. And that is the crisis, that is the fundamental crisis of the African-American community and the fundamental crisis of the African-American church. Black men are not there to be counted. And every time you hear about a black man, you sort of freeze, because you always think that something negative is going to come down. And 9 out of 10 times, it's something negative. And so what we are trying to turn that around, that every time when we bring these black men back to church and give them the principles and teachings and the ethics of Jesus Christ our Lord, and the saving grace of the gospel is going to transform not only the church and the family, but it's going to transform society. And I'm going to give you one example. If black men are back in church, the crime rate will go down by 50%.
Amen.
We like the crime rate. Dr. Williams, you had a question about this because we had another pastor on talking about this very topic some months ago, and it's a topic that's near and dear to your heart.
Yes. One of the questions is, when does this program begin, and is it an ongoing program?
Yeah, this program began on September 25th, which is the fourth Sunday of the month. And this program does not end until 10 years from them. 10 years. So 2021 is when this program would end. And by that time, I have promised the Lord that I will use the power of the National Black Church Initiative to bring 10 million black men back to church. Now, let me be very clear. It will not be me that bring them back to church. It will be the Lord. He will be bringing them back to church. What God wants the black church to do is call them out and tell them three particular things. One, that we absolutely fundamentally love you. Two, we understand what you are going through. And three, we miss you. And what churches should do is try to respond to those three particular calls. So what we asking churches to do is to join this initiative, not for the National Black Church Initiative, but for the Lord Jesus Christ. So we asking them to make sure that they designate 10 strong black Christian in their congregation to serve as evangelists for this single purpose of bringing black men back to church. So every black church in America should have 10 men committed to bringing other black men back to church. Number two, you should go online within 20 days from now on our website, www.naltblackchurch.com, all one word. Order your kit. We have a kit of posters, postcards, and everything that you will need in order to advertise what your church is doing by bringing black men to church. So the literature is going to have a spot where you put in your church address, so that the black man would know where to come to. So you're going to pass these out in the community, talk to him about Christ, and give him a paper where your church is at, so they can come back to church. And when they do that, don't be surprised that the church will have a spiritual revolution. Now, this is not going to be easy, so some people are excited about it. When the men come back to church, when they are serious about worshiping God, then a lot of foolishness in the church has to leave.
Now, you have a lot of statistics proving that the church is overwhelmingly attended today by women. Is that true?
Oh, absolutely. In some congregations, the women outnumber men 80 to 20.
Now, one of the other benefits...
They outnumber men 60 to 40.
Well, those are not statistics. We want to even those odds out. Now, there's also some other information that you have that people can also give out to their local church, they can give out to their local communities. To the person that's listening right now, that African-American male that might be listening right now, can you talk to that person as we close out the last couple of minutes? Can you talk to that person listening right now?
If you are a black male and you're outside the church, you are employed or unemployed, one of the crises that you face is direction. You don't know what direction to go into. You don't know to go east, west, north, or south. Whatever lifestyle you are living now, you know it's going to end up badly because you have seen your friends do it. So what we are saying to you is that the black church loves you. Come to us. Let us and the Lord burden, take your burdens away from you. Ease your mind because you are not in the right position that God wants you to be in. God wants you to be in the position that you are a leader. God wants you to be in the position that you are a father. God wants you to be in the position that you are a husband. And God wants you to be in the position that you are a provider. So what you really need, the first step you need to do is pray a prayer of repentance, of atonement. Say, God, forgive me what I have done. Please straighten me out. And then the second thing you need to do is find yourself a black church to go to. And when you have done those two things, on the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, your whole life will go through a revolutionary change over the next year.
Now, Dr. Williams, those people that say, hey, why is this singling out a certain group of people? What does Dr. Evans say about that? And Dr. Williams, I know you had your own opinion about that as well.
Yes, we're talking about it. We're the National Black Church Initiative, and we know that in our communities, that's where the crime rate is. We know in our communities, that's where a lot of the problems exhibit from. We know in our communities, those are the people who are going to jail. And we know that God is the only thing that can change that around. The black church needs to take control of this situation, and the only way we can do that is by inviting our black men back to church and getting them the principles that are needed so that they can get back on the right track. I've been doing this. I'm a part of the, I'm the Northeast Faith Command of the National Black Church Initiative, and for the past 2 or 3 months I've been inviting black men to church everywhere I've preached, everywhere I've gone, in the restaurants that I've sat in, and I have not had one who has said that they won't be in a church that day. Now, if they show up or not, then maybe a different story, but I expect my church to be overfilled with black men on the 25th of September because of the invitations that are not only going out by me, but they're going out by our congregation. I know that this radio program here is also going to bring a lot of black men into church on this Sunday.
Dr. Evans, why don't we give you the last word?
Absolutely. I want to echo what Pastor Sheldon Williams have said, but let me leave you and your viewers with this. When we bring black men back to church, then the church is doing what God wants them to do. The church don't want us to become a movie. God don't want the church to become a movie theater. The church has one particular mission, and that is to win souls for Christ. And when we start doing what God has instructed us to do, just like in Second Chronicle, He will heal the land. And right now, the land needs to be healing. There's unemployment that is rampant. No one has jobs. There's hopelessness and despair. And I can't think of a better time to make this call and to shut up our critics who telling us what the black church should be about. But look, when we are doing positive things like calling black men back to church, our critics, we don't hear from them. But I can tell you now, but when they come back to church, and I know they will over the next 10 years. That's why we're giving it 10 years. We know that no miracle happens only when God allow it to happen. We're giving it 10 years. And when they come back to church, they're going to transform themselves, the church, the community, and this entire society. In the name of Jesus, that's who is our boss and our leader in this movement.
Well, we want to thank you so much for coming and sharing this initiative through the WMCA 570 AM airwaves on the PCL radio show. Folks, all I can say is if you're listening right now, you want more information, you would like to get involved, you want to donate, you want to learn more about this initiative and how we all can help, even you as an individual, call our office, 718-513-4648. Again, 718-513-4648. One more time, that number is 718-513-4648. We want you to stay tuned. Dr. Williams and I will be right back after this brief commercial break.